Okay, how are we doing? This is lesson 49. This is solving rate problems with proportions and equations. I'm on page 330. This goes to 335. Bottom of 330, recall that rate is a ratio of two measures. For example, speed is a rate that is a ratio of distance and time. What we want to remember is that ratios are constant and unit rates are constant. So as one goes up, the other one goes up by the same ratio. So let's go ahead and jump over to example one. And example one says, if six books weighs 15 pounds, how much would 20 books weigh? Okay, so we're going to have books, and we're just going to set up our tables. In the weight, we have six books. They weigh 15 pounds, so 20 books would weigh P. And we just set up our ratios. 6 over 15 is equivalent to 20 over P. And just remember, we're going to multiply the loop. 20 times 15 is 15 times 2, 30. The zero is 300. Divided by what's left over? 6. 300 divided by 6 is 50. So if 6 books weighs 15 pounds, 20 books weighs 50 pounds. Again, multiply the loop, divide by what is left over. Example 2. If 6 books weighs 15 pounds, what is the unit rate? Unit rate means 1. Okay? So we're just going to come in here and say if 6 books weighs 15 pounds, same thing. Books. Wait, 6 books weighs 15 pounds. Unit rate means what does 1 book cost? Okay, over P. So we're going to say 6 over 15 is the same as 1 over P. Multiply the loop. 15 times 1 is 15. Divide by what's left over. 6, 15 divided by 6 is 2.5. Okay, so unit. Rate. They're looking for 1. Now let's move over to example 3. Example 3 says Julio's riding in a 50-kilometer bike race. He passed the 15-kilometer mark in 27 minutes. If Julio continues to ride at the same rate, what will be his time for the whole race? I think we can do that as long as we remember how to set up our ratio tables. Okay. So we'll say Julio has a distance and a time. We'll set up the table here. Distance is 15. The time was 27. So for a distance of 50, we have a time of m. So our ratios are 15 to 27. Good morning. Equals 50 over m. Multiply the loop. Divide by what's left over. So 27 times 50 is 0, 35, 13, 50. 1350 divided by what's left over, 15. 15 can't go into 13, but it can go into 135. Let me see, 15 times 9, 135, 0 with a leftover 0, so 90. What does this look like if Julio can go 15 kilometers in 27 minutes? He can go 50 kilometers in 90 minutes. So far, so good. That'll take us up to example 4. Example 4 looks a little something like this. In example three, what is Julio's rate in kilometers per minute? Okay, so we knew in our table that we had distance and time. Okay, so we had kilometers for distance and time we had minutes. They just want to know what is the rate and the ratio of kilometers per minute. So it's just 15 kilometers for every 27 minutes. We can reduce that, divide both by 3, 5 kilometers per 9 minutes. That's the ratio. Okay. Last one, example 5. All right, here we are with example 5. 3 tickets cost $20.25. How much would 7 tickets cost? What is the unit cost? Okay, so I'm making a little table here. We have tickets here over price. And we have 3 tickets is $20.25. So we're wondering, first of all, what 7 tickets would cost. And we see in our table we have a ratio of 3 to $20.25 is the same as 7 over P. So all we have to do, that's a 7, by the way. This times this, multiply the loop, divide by what's left over. So $20.25 times 7. 7 times 5 is 35. Put down the 5, carry the 3. 7 times 2 is 14, plus 3 is 17, 7 and 1. 7 times 0 plus 1 and 141. Okay. So now we multiply the loop, divide by what's left, that's the 3, 141.75. That's another 7 in there, divided by 3. 3 does not go into 1, but it does go into 14 4 times. Subtract 12 is 2. Bring down the 1. 3 goes into 21 7 times. It's a 7 again right there. All right, goes into 7 2 times. 2 times 2 is 6. 1, 5. 3 goes into 15. 5 times. So this is what we're thinking right now. 3 tickets would be $20.25. 7 tickets would be $47.25. Let's just see if that's reasonable, if that makes sense. $20.25 for 3 tickets, so 6 tickets would be double that. That would be $40.50. Plus another ticket, that would be $6.75. So what we're guessing right now is our unit rate, or 1, would be $6.75. So let's see if that's true. Again, unit is 1. Okay, so 3 over $20.25 is the same as 1 over P. Multiply the loop, divide by what's left, $20.25 divided by 3. 3 cannot go into 2, but it can go into 20 6 times. Subtract 18, we have a 2, bring down the 2. 3 can go into 22 7 times, subtract 21. We have 1, bring down the 5. 3 can go into 15 5 times, subtract 15 is 0. So this is what we know. Unit rate for 1 is $6.75, about 7. So for 3 times 7, close to 20.25, and then 7 times 7, 47.25 is close to 49. So this makes sense. Our unit rate is $6.75, and then 7 tickets is $47.25. All right, good luck. You are now on page 333 to 335, 1 through 30. If you need help, come and see me. If you have significant problems, we'll go over the practice set together on page 333, and I can help you out there. So good luck with lesson 40.